Wow. Wow.
Adam, I have awful news.
Evan, don't come in. Do you want to watch a kid's show?
Mano, please, it's not finished. You're gonna ruin it.
That's a nice table, honestly.
Rich people.
Yeah.
Rich French people.
Are there any poor French people?
Of course not. Not in this show.
Ugh. That face close up.
Man, she crushed you, huh? Better luck next time. Huh? What's the big deal?
You only lost by 500,000 votes. What a dick. What's his deal?
Stormy weather. I am Hawkmoth. I give you the power to seek revenge on them as my weather girl.
I forgot how much they just throw in.
Where's Mirai?
Anime convention's down the street.
I thought cats always landed on their feet.
Why, thanks, m'ladybug, but I had covered.
No time for your childish charge.
It's Fran. I'm in pain.
Fine. I'll go ahead and clean it, but don't blame me if I come across any of your private stuff, like your emails, your diaries.
Okay.
She's gonna see I'm a fucking crazy person. She's gonna see how much I like this boy in class and ban me from leaving the house ever again.
She's gonna see the zucchini I've carved his face into.
Oh, all right. So, Evan, what did we just watch? What was that all about?
You know, I can't remember the name.
Miraculous Ladybug, Tales of Ladybug and Cat Noir.
It is easily... It's easy to call, and I think the pilot was the worst about this.
Sure.
Sensory overload.
This is Mano, one of my mom's friend's daughters. I'm watching her all afternoon.
Slow
down. Can I go out?
Down.
Yes. You couldn't say no favor.
No, I just...
There can't be so much substance here that you can't fit it in 20
Look,
minutes.
No problem. I'll look after
her mouth.
Yeah.
There is too much shit going on at any given second. And they're just jumping and jumping and jumping to all these different plot points so quickly.
We're gonna stroll over there real cool as if we just happened to be passing by.
Let's have two kits, no three. And a dog! Maybe a cat. Nah, forget the cat. A hamster! I love hamsters!
Get out of my damn face!
If you took all of these episodes, doubled the length, you might really have something substantial.
Yeah.
But also, I would not watch this for 45 minutes. Like a single, story thread to be tied up. So I get that they're dealing with more of a delicate balance there.
Mm-hmm. I think you're right. And it's funny because now that it actually is, I think, picked up by Netflix.
Oh.
So
did it start out with
It started
Netflix?
On like Nickelodeon.
That makes sense.
And then I think Netflix like has the license now.
Okay.
So I think that's when season two is going to be released.
How many? Okay, so they got through one season on Nickelodeon.
Yeah,
before
and
they
a
got
Christmas special
dropped.
With songs.
It's Christmas in Paris, all is cheery and bright, but I am all alone tonight. There's no warmth for me, no tenderness for me. I'm alone like a cat in the night.
So we watched the first episode.
To start out, yeah.
Yeah, and who is the villain of that? Weather Girl?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
What? Stormy
day. Weather. Stormy Weather.
I am Stormy Weather, the only weather girl who always gets the forecast right.
You know, I thought the way they introduced all that, I thought those characters would stick.
Yeah.
That's just dropped all of that. Like the weather girls and the contest, and it's just like...
They bring, the contest back, like that setting.
They make it, like, the characters too?
Not the Stormy Weather Girl, like the guy, like the Howie Mandel.
This is the moment we've been waiting for!
Howie Mandel?
So, episode one, essentially, there's a contest held by Howie Mandel, as we've said. and it's between two girls. It's like, who's the prettiest? Who's, I don't remember what, it's like a popularity
to
contest.
To be the weather girl of...
Was it to be the weather girl? I missed that detail, and then I didn't understand why they she could control weather.
Yeah.
Or, like, could freeze specifically.
It was who was going to be Something Network's new weather girl.
Okay. A little young to work at a fucking TV station as a weather girl.
Absolutely way too young. There's a big creepy factor to that for me.
Yeah.
And
the men
girl,
will love it.
The girl that... Put a little something for daddy in there. That girl loses her mind over not being the weather girl. Not an anchor. Not a field journalist.
Yeah.
The weather girl.
Yeah, she goes...
And like I stated when we were watching it, from what we saw, I don't understand why she lost. And she got pummeled by this girl that has no on-screen presence.
But with the help of our audience at home, we whittled our talent down to just these two amazing young ladies.
To my right, Aurora Boreal, and on my left, Mirai Kake.
Oh, is that a camera? I get shy, I get nervous. Why would you not have somebody that's like bubbly, energetic, passionate, obviously extroverted, with good, like a persona that meshes well on screen?
Yeah.
Why would that person lose in a landslide?
You only lost by
half a million votes.
I don't get it.
I don't understand.
Just so she can like go off the deep end and have this ridiculous costume and then just go around Paris murdering random people and putting domes over just stuff.
Yeah. So the main character is Marinette, and
she's loud.
In the daytime, she's Marinette.
In the daytime, I'm Marinette.
And
loud.
Yeah, and loud. Just a normal, average girl.
She works from 9 to 5.
No, I'm trying to remember the intro. Just a normal girl with a normal life. But I have a secret.
Just a normal girl with a normal life.
That no one knows about. You know what my favorite part about that is? She says that no one knows yet, as if she's intending to tell everyone at some point. Like that one knows yet.
That's gonna be a plot point at some point.
Do you think she'll like reverse their knowledge?
Yes, I was about to say exactly that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Because that would make some sense.
And then somebody's gonna like find a clue, and they'll be like, huh. And then they'll never extrapolate on it.
Yeah.
Seen it 100 times.
Yeah. That's for sure what it's going to be. So, you asshole.
I asked.
So, yeah. In the daytime, she's Marinette. And...
Marionette.
Yeah, Marinette.
She's a puppet.
Oh.
She's a marionette.
Oh. Were you going to... Shit, my phone! So in the daytime, she's Marinette. You okay?
How many more times are we gonna fucking say it? I get it.
Because then we had a bad take with the phone. So I was redoing it. Jeez, all right. So anyway, she's the lady. She's the Miraculous Ladybug. And
that's a
superhero
name, which is weird.
What, Miraculous? What?
Yeah.
I mean, she's just Ladybug, but her, like, it's like Amazing Spider-Man.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
So she's Spider-Man?
Yeah, no, she's literally French Spider-Man. Exactly.
That is blatant, now that you put it like that.
See, I never really made that comparison, but,
wow.
Like, I never thought about it in that, like, blatant sense, but... It really is just Miraculous Ladybug, Amazing Spider-Man. And I think it's fine, honestly.
I guess.
I think that's why I like it so much, is because it's very close to Spider-Man. And see, I've just been easing you up. At the beginning, I was like, I kind of like this show. Halfway through, I was like, yeah, this is why I enjoy it. And now I'm just like, it's why I really like this show. I've just been slowly telling you my actual feelings on this show.
You've been coming out to me about your
Mom,
feelings.
Dad, I have something to tell you. I like Miraculous Ladybug.
Damn it, Adam, why can't you just be gay? Why do you have to be a disappointment?
Because, because I have something else to tell you, Mom.
We found your cat suit.
Whoa, kitty, kitty. You better think before you leave.
You got a plan?
Stroke is fucking... Yeah. That's all my eyes were drawn to.
Yeah, same. There's like something weirdly sexual about this whole thing. And it's not necessary at all.
But I had it covered.
Huh? No time for your childish charm, Cat Noir.
But yeah, so Adrian is Cat Noir, and he has like they transform Sailor Moon style. And if you see cosplayers in these costumes, it's really bad. Oh yeah. Oh dude, there's insane cosplays by this. The Cat Noir ones are a lot better than the Ladybug ones because
in the insane part, are girls doing both roles?
Oh yeah. Okay. Oh yeah. Okay. There was no question.
Okay.
But the Ladybug ones in most cases just look like fucking pajamas. Like, the people just look like they're right. Just wearing fucking pajamas. And, I mean, a lot of them are kids, so it's like, alright, whatever.
No, fuck kids. They don't get a pass.
As you can see, I actually did intentionally wear Ladybug colors. I wore red and black because I was like, I want to theme this a little bit.
That's pushing it on the red.
I mean, it's like maroon, sort of. Mm-hmm. This is part of the Oxenfree cosplay.
It's
got to
be sharp. Headache inducing red.
It's gotta be neon. No.
I did like the color.
Dude, it's a really pretty show. Mm-hmm. It's really nice looking.
Sometimes I look at the visuals and there's these shots or these moments. Most of my gripes with the animation, we can get into that later, but the lighting, the colors, most of the character design is pretty standout. It's not ugly.
Everyone's a fucking fashion designer in this show or something.
That's
what Marinette wants to be, like, and that's what Adrian's dad is.
Why would she want to be... Holy shit. That's like Batman being like, I want to be a firefighter. You're a fucking superhero. Is that not enough?
I mean, I assume that's what she wanted to be before...
You do have to pay the rent, too.
Yeah, exactly. Being a superhero doesn't pay the rent. You're not getting handed big old checks. I think there was a plot in a Spider-Man where he got a check from, like, the mayor or somebody. Mm-hmm. Like, it wasn't, like, a big old fucking cartoon check. Mm-hmm. But, and he goes to cash it in. And they're like, you can't fucking sign this as Spider-Man? What are you doing, fucko? And they're like, we can't cash this. We can take
this
off
is,
your mask.
This
like,
is play money.
Get out of here with your
How do
Canadian
we know you're
Monopoly
Spider-Man?
No,
you just be a cosplayer.
No, it's not about if they know you're Spider-Man. It's that's not an identity.
Exactly,
I mean, there is
yeah.
something kind of flawed with going to the bank and being like, let me open... What was he going to open a new account under Spider-Man? Was he trying to put it under Peter Parker?
Man P. Spider... Savings.
I don't know why.
Oh, fuck. I don't have a social.
I don't know why that was so funny to me.
Time flies fast when you're saving the world. Day's already over.
Tell me about it. I missed an entire half day of school.
Did I ask for your fucking opinion?
So, anyway, they outwit Lady Weather, whatever the fuck.
Outwit.
But.
I guess. She didn't really.
Yeah, let's talk about the fight.
Did she do anything?
She did her ladybug sense. And
no, I'm talking about Weather Girl.
But that's how they outwitted her. Or you're talking like she didn't do anything.
Did
like
she, weather didn't she girl. Just hover there?
Okay, this is interesting. That kind of squealing squeak kind
of. I thought her head was gonna get taken off.
Just crack her right in half, 90 degrees over there.
It looked like a crane was about to take her head off, but instead it knocked the umbrella out of her hands that was like a half a foot above her head.
And it didn't break, but it broke over the girl's knee, if I'm not mistaken.
Or she just.
Get out of here, you nasty bug! No more evil doing for you, little Akuma.
Akuma means devil in Japanese.
Time to de-evilize! Gotcha! Bye-bye, little butterfly.
Better get used to those, like, three lines.
But yeah, that is strange. It's like a fucking crane going, boom, didn't break it, but...
5,000 pounds of solid steel.
I mean, we were joking that it would take her head off, so it's like...
one so. Skinny girl's knee. She does a lot of, like, acrobatic, really physical things.
Ladybug?
Yeah. Can she do that kind of stuff when she doesn't
when
have
she,
her powers
when she
activated?
Isn't spotted on? I don't... That's a good question. I mean...
What is she doing to stay in shape? She's not, like, a gymnast? Don't see her pumping
see, that,
iron.
That's, I think I did have that, like, that thought did occur to me when I was watching the show myself.
Kind of vague what their powers are.
Yeah, is
she
if,
gets a yo-yo and she's extremely gifted with it. Like, did that come with the ring?
That's, the ring is
oh,
Cat Noir. She's got the earrings.
Earring.
But, yeah, that is a question that did occur to me too, is like, so does the athleticism come with the suit? Or like,
are
with
these
what?
Kids just like, should be in the... fucking French Olympic team.
I mean, I don't know.
Do you remember that big gorilla, like, bodyguard guy that we see
that
briefly?
That was Adrian's bodyguard. It's not really elaborated in that episode,
okay.
But that is...
I still don't know the origin story. I'm guessing that these kids are not the first ones to end up with these powers. Just the kind of vibe I'm getting from that.
Really?
Because, well, there's that really old dude who knows what they are.
All you have to do is bring me the miraculous. Can you do that?
Like the main villain.
Yeah.
He knows what they are. He's clearly older than them. So it's probably like a passed down thing.
I'll get into a little bit of the lore of this show.
Hold
one
on,
of the ones
hold on.
Oh, okay.
What like how fucking goofy would it be if that enormous gorilla dude was, you know, the one who ended up somebody like him ended up with the ladybug one? He does his little Sailor Moon dance. Does his has the annoying little fairy with him. Yeah. And it just puts him in, like, a skin-tight, red and black bodysuit. I'd watch that.
Yeah.
I'd be on.
It'd be great.
Yeah.
That'd be good. If you're listening, Zagtoon, if that is, I think that's your name.
If that is your real name.
That is your real production company. But then episode 3 is, I think, the one we watched next. And that was Lady Wi-Fi. We skipped over 1, I think. And it sounds really... really lame.
I still love the name.
It's pretty good.
Really stepped up, and I do appreciate it. Now it's time to move on to our next assignment.
Who does that?
Is Marinette still in the girls' room?
Oh, it's you.
It's Marinette. Leave a message. Beep.
I'm gonna do a Lady Wi-Fi cosplay.
Do it.
I'm just gonna walk around my fucking phone. Gonna get a black t-shirt
and just like
cut a Wi-Fi logo onto it. That's gonna be it. I'm just gonna like walk around cons with my face fucking buried in my phone, and I'm not gonna make eye contact with anybody.
So you're gonna be a regular con goer
with some fucking paper taped to my chest. Yeah,
with the Wi-Fi. Yeah. Lady, just a black shirt and yeah. like
3 strips of paper and a circle at the bottom.
Someone's like, are you something? I'm Lady Wi-Fi.
I'm not him. I leave.
Chloe! Alia's looking in your locker! It's Marinette. message. Beep.
So Lady Wi-Fi essentially pauses people.
Stay connected.
Why was she akumatized, essentially? The reason was...
Should we even explain what that means? That means, like, a regular person has been turned into...
Like a weird supervillain by this guy, Hawk Moth.
Ah, school life. Such a science experiment. A petri dish of cultivating secrets, lies, and betrayal.
Can you tell he feeds off negative emotions yet?
Fly away, my little Akuma, and evilize her.
Who is the main baddie?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, and he's another character that's just, like, shown.
An object that a random person, often a side character, is holding, is turned into,
whatever the Akuma goes in. I mean, right. It's, I don't...
It gets kind of, like, infected by an evil butterfly, and they get mind-controlled by the main baddie, and their powers are based around that object. I mean, that's a pretty simple premise, but... It can create for some interesting villains. I mean, it's going to get to the point where they're like, how do we make a fucking handbag interesting? But I don't know. I haven't seen the whole season. Maybe they do that.
I think there is a handbag at some point. I don't know what it is. It's novel. It's very formulaic. That's what I told him that it's like kids. Even some of the same. I there's the parts where she like gets the butterfly and makes it good again. And...
Kids
she makes
love
the butterfly
routine.
Great again. And what?
Kids love routine.
Yeah, and I mean, it's a little charming, but it is kind of... That is just kind of what the show sort of is. I think you said at some point, I don't know if it was during this, I know you said, did it scratch the Code Lyoko itch? And yeah. it definitely did for me.
Yeah.
Because that show has such a weird, like, it's very... Like, the dialogue isn't great... The animations, the 3D animation is not great.
Jerky.
The 2D is fine. The 2D is okay, if I remember correctly. I rewatched like all of it a couple years ago.
I thought we were talking about Ladybug.
Oh no, sorry. I was just totally okay real quick. Yeah. But just something about the French, man. They make like really weirdly charming TV shows that are easy to really get into. At least, I mean, in case, like, you'd agree, Code Lyoko, I think both are. Yeah, so her friend gets akumatized because she's like, oh, no one believes me, she got suspended from school.
That doesn't get resolved. She gets suspended for some pretty legit reasons.
Yeah.
I mean, she's taking creep shots of a girl.
She's trying to see if Chloe is Ladybug. She, like, cuts out the face of
Chloe
Ladybug in a picture and is, like, holding it up to people.
The token Starbucks, like, popular white girl. Like, she's like...
Chloe Bourgeois.
The real Ladybug is Chloe Bourgeois, everyone.
The rich girl's name is Bourgeois.
Chloe Bourgeois is like, what's the girl from Mean Girls?
I haven't seen Mean Girls.
Shit.
I really... Everyone I say that to is like, wait, you haven't seen Mean Girls? Mostly girls. But, I don't know.
What are you getting at, Adam?
I was saying that mostly girls say that.
It's good. It's funny. It's overrated.
Mean Girls review. Hot takes. Meme Girls.
Check your expectations.
Meme Girl? Did I just say Meme Girls? Oh, my fucking Lord. I'm sorry.
Just like Adamnator.com, check your expectations at the door.
Thanks for that.
You're welcome. I love you.
Oh, how could you just...
Man, don't be so down on yourself, man.
So
lots of people do.
Anyway.
Taking creep shots, going through a fucking locker.
Yeah,
that's where I really draw the line. Cause
did she only take a picture of it, or did she like reach in? Because I don't really remember.
She went through her locker.
Oh,
at least that's what the dialogue said. Like, somebody was like, "Well, she was going through my locker," or no, she broke into my locker, and she's like, "I didn't break in,"
but she did. I think she only took the picture because Chloe's in the fucking picture.
I didn't break into her locker; it was open.
And nothing was stolen then?
Only my very soul.
She took a picture of it, and then the argument is, I didn't steal anything. The principal's like, so nothing was stolen, and she's like, no, and then Chloe's like, well, I'm gonna call my dad, and then he's just like, oh, okay, you're suspended.
Wait till my father hears about this.
Wait till my father hears about this, Potter. Very, you know, and why do the dickheads always have blonde hair? Sorry. I didn't mean for that generalization to encompass you. There was an implied
okay.
In media.
No, let's get into this. You want to know why the dickheads always have blonde hair?
Sure.
Europe, 1914. War were declared. Europe is ravished over the course of 4 years by an enormous bloodshed.
And Dr. Seuss went on to make political cartoons. No, yeah, Dr. Seuss made like a thing of like, it was like Hitler nibbling away at like a tree, like as like a
who?
Woodpecker. Dr. Seuss made a political cartoon
of whom?
And it's Hitler as a bird.
Don't know him.
Christ. And he's like nibbling away at a tree.
Yeah.
And then there's like a bunch of other trees, like Poland is like fucking down on the ground, and there's like a bunch of other countries that are down on the ground.
That's clever.
And there's another little creature sitting on top of a little like of the America tree, and it's just like, ho hum, but he gets to us, he'll surely be done or something. And it's just like,
man, I love
shit.
Those old ads.
Ads?
That they're advertising. Propaganda's advertising.
That's fair.
They played them as commercials before movies and stuff.
Did they?
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if they played the Donald Duck Becomes a Nazi one before.
Oh, yeah. No, that was one you go to the theaters to see.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Let's go to the theaters to see your beloved character become a fucking Nazi.
Oh, I wish I could do a fucking Donald Duck voice.
No, it's not very good.
I wanted to do Donald Duck yelling.
My grandma can do it real good.
I wanted to do Donald Duck just yelling, "Die Juden!
Die Führer! Die Führer!"
I can't do it very well.
I think we've digressed a little
yeah,
far.
Yeah, we've digressed a bit. But anyway, so Lady Wi-Fi gets taken down. Talking about Donald Duck being a Nazi. So Lady Wi-Fi. So do you want to say anything about the m'ladies that frequent Miraculous Ladybug episodes? Cat Noir calls Ladybug m'lady, and this happens frequently. Like, if you keep watching.
Oh, I only heard it once.
It's in a lot of the episodes.
I buried my head in my hands, if I remember correctly.
You did something. I remember that. You were not okay.
It did
you were upset
something to me.
And I can understand, but it is it, like my
tips,
excuse is it is French.
Tips ears.
Tips his ears. My excuse is, like, it is French, but at the same time...
It's dubbed.
It's still... Yeah. I really want to know who the voice actor is.
I want to look at a list of the voice actors, because two of them, one for certain to me, sounds like they were in Skyrim. I've played a lot of Skyrim, like a lot of people have. And when you only have, I think, 13 voice actors for a game with...
Really?
Yeah, with like
thousands
over 1,000 characters,
yeah.
You recognize people's voices. Bethesda games tend to not have too many voice actors in them.
Huh. And I'll put it up. I'll put it up on the screen right now if it's, yeah.
Do you get to the Cloud District very often?
Your mask will fall one day, Ladybug. You'll have no choice then but to hand over your precious Miraculous.
So they defeat Lady Wi-Fi with something. I forget what.
A microwave.
Oh, yeah, they fucked up.
No. Suddenly, the cat guy has the power to just oxidize metal.
That's what his...
Lady Wi-Fi is standing upon a cell tower.
Cataclysm. That's the cataclysm.
Yeah, and he uses this power, and it just fucking brings the cell tower down.
Like, she could have been seriously hurt. It was, like, I think he knew it was her friend. His friend.
Thousands of dollars of damage. They for sure knew
it was her. But it was Miraculous Ladybug, probably back to normal.
Can she do that?
That's what happens with the ice. Like, she does that with, like, physical things. Like, cars are upturned, the city's in disarray, and she just, like, does the... And then the whole thing gets...
Do you think it just, like, fixes unrelated shit? Like, somebody's just, like, plunging his toilet, and then he just...
feels toilet gets magical, re-clogged.
No. he feels this magical sensation, and then just like it's suddenly clear. It just like fixes random things that had nothing to do with.
That'd be pretty great. I hope.
Because how?
That, I can only imagine.
That raises so many questions. Are their powers connected to the evil people's powers, so that way it only undoes the things they did, and or does it like reverse time or what?
No, it doesn't reverse time because everyone remembers it. It just reverses like the. I don't know what it does, but it has some sort of.
I mean, you don't really
quantum
need to explain it.
It has
away,
some sort of quantum mechanic.
We've already read far too much into a show that is just supposed to be bright colors, loud sounds, easy to follow plot for tiny little kids that can't sit still for 5 seconds.
Seriously? Has your dad always been such a downer? You think he'd at least remember what it was like to be young and want to party a little?
So, episode three, it was the third one we watched. It was, I think it was 11. The Bubbler was his name.
The Bubbler.
No, I'm pretty sure he was a downer back then too. Well, at least I tried. It's your B-Day, dude! Incest!
You can do it.
Incest!
I can do it!
That's all I heard. What was he trying to say?
Insist, I think. It's Adrian's friend who really wants his dad to let him have a birthday party, because it's his birthday.
I thought the character design of the actual villain, the Bumbler himself,
yeah,
I could not make up how I felt about that.
Really?
Because at some points, like, I really liked the, like, seeing a villain that's just in a bunch of bright colors. No black. I mean, a little bit on his face. Like, spots, I think. And
he had, like, only two spots.
Yeah. And, I mean, that's fine. But he also just looked like a toy at some parts.
Yeah.
Which I think they were kind of going for.
Sorry, Bubbler, but the party's over.
Why you gotta be like that?
Bro, dude.
Bro, man, dude. When he was talking to Adrian's dad, and he was just being like, dude, sir.
Adrian's not home yet.
I was coming to see you, sir.
I think his head was like a Teletubby head, and it could... Was it?
Yeah.
Did it have, like, the bubble?
It
might have.
It waggled. It waggled. It was red. Little phallic.
Hey, you! Why aren't you having fun?
None of your business.
Fuck off. You call my family poor?
Bubbler is bubbling up all the adults. Because he's like totally like
now, what
the fuck the adult.
What does that mean, bubbling them up? He's making their blood boil, and they burst through their skin, right?
Of course, he puts them in bubbles, and they go like 100 feet in the air.
Dad!
That's gotta be the most terror. That like, imagine how terrifying that would be,
dude.
They're all like
they had to
life.
Have been. High up, because we later see our heroes being catapulted higher than the Eiffel Tower. No bubbles in sight anywhere.
That's interesting.
Should we see if you land on your feet this time?
You should have thought this through.
Oh my god.
Cats always land on their feet and he just turns to fucking pulp as he hits the cement.
What's wrong with all you guys? Why you gotta be such haters?
I'll block you on Twitter. The executives making this show. My son doesn't respect me.
What, are you going somewhere with this?
Yeah. What if we have an episode where it's just like, you know, adults are... They're good. And they protect you.
Yeah.
And they give you your fucking Chuck E. Cheese birthday party that you ask for 100 times. Yet you still find a little bitch.
And when they're returned, they're teleported back in the bubbles, and then the bubble pops.
Interesting.
There's just like
inconsistencies.
No...
Oh, totally unrighteous.
There's like no rules on the magic in that world.
Yeah.
It's just kind of
like, yeah, I mean, with
Which
magic,
like
you can kind of do whatever you want in a show.
But then it's just like implied to be magic.
Yeah.
I'm
curious. It is. It's totally magic. Like, that's like all
okay.
the thing.
I'm curious where it comes from.
What, though. Like their powers?
Yeah.
So, okay, spoilers here on out. Like, if you care. Like, honestly, you should watch the show. And it's kind of neat seeing it develop, but it does take a lot of episodes for it to do so.
Don't watch it alone unless you're, like, him.
Unless you're fucking weird.
Hey, girls!
Nice scarf.
So, yeah, spoilers if you care. So, basically, those little, there's a word for them. It's like the little, like the red one and the black one that Adrian has.
I think fairy's a good word if you can't
remember. They're technically fairies.
That's essentially what they are. Little hovering little things that are fucking irritating as all hell.
They're weird to look at, but I think they're a little, they're kind
of
charming.
I like the design of one of them.
The black one.
They annoy the shit out of me. Mm-hmm. And one gives horrible advice.
The black one did. It's like twice.
We'll say the cat one.
The cat one.
What's your problem? Relax. You're getting the party you always wanted.
So essentially they are like super ancient. Like there's an episode where it's like a Egypt exhibit and someone gets turned into like, they think they're like an old pharaoh and they try to use like a human sacrifice to bring back their...
Jesus.
to bring back like
their
girlfriend. Why didn't you
lead with that? That sounds awesome.
I mean, it's kind of cool. And then in an even later episode... There's a book Adrian is looking at, I think from the library, and it shows, this is like the last one of the season, I think, and it shows really old portrait of Ladybug, really old portrait of Cat Noir, really old portrait of Hawk Moth. He has a little fucking guy in like one of the last episodes of the season. It's like a little gray dude. And it's funny because like I laughed out loud because in the show, the guy's like, his like little fairy is like, you shouldn't use your powers for evil, and he just goes, I'm your master now or something, and he's just like, oh,
those things have to obey whoever controls them.
Yeah, that's why he,
what if
that's
it
why
just
he
doesn't give him his powers.
I don't
like
think
stick needles in
it. He's gonna, dude, I mean, that's what would happen if the government found him. Like, imagine like fucking Tiki on like
I delight at the thought.
What, plaque? It's either plaque or just black. I think it's plaque though, is the name of the cat one. But just on like a fucking operating table and like their stomachs open and they're just like writhing in pain.
They're immortal, right?
I imagine.
I think it's implied.
Like, there's an old guy who, even in the intro, you can see a green one flying, you can see, like, another color, like, you see the, like, pale one, which is Hawk Moth's, you see, you know, like, a few other little dudes, and so
it's in the intro?
It's in the fucking intro.
Honestly, I am drawing a blank completely when I'm trying to remember the intro.
Really? Like, on there, like, even being one, or?
I feel like
you don't remember it at all.
It's a kid's show, so there has to be one. But I try to remember it.
Look close.
I'm trying to remember.
Oh.
And there's nothing.
So I think there's like a couple more that like even haven't been in or mentioned. But...
Okay. Yeah. The intro is coming back to me. That part is not, because
like,
it's such an enfilade.
Yeah. She's on top of the fucking Eiffel Tower.
Shit
and
that
just
happens.
Like
the rest of the show. It's just, bam, this happening, bam, this is happening, bam, this is happening, before you can process what you just saw.
Yeah.
So.
Like, I would sometimes, like.
I'll watch for
be
that
doing something
the next time.
While, like, I'm watching it on, like, I might be, like, making a fucking omelet, and it's, like, right here.
Yeah.
And I might look away to, like, flip the omelet, and then I look over, and I miss, like, 2 seconds, and it's, like, the most important fucking plot point. Or,
dude,
like,
I feel like the whole show's like that. You, like, look away for 10 seconds, you come back, and it's like, well,
like, who
I'm
are these 10 people?
I'm completely fucking lost. Where are they? What is happening?
Yeah.
What are the stakes?
So, yeah, you know, it's just kind of dumb high school crush bullshit. Like, Cat Noir likes Ladybug, Marinette, human, likes Adrian, but they don't know that they're always crime-fighting in Miladian. Man, that was... I remember when I first watched that episode, because I think that happened in... that did happen in episode one, where he's just like, we got this, Milady, or something, and I was...
Tips cat ears.
Why, thanks, Miladybug.
If you liked Code Lyoko, you'll probably like this. If you like cartoons, you'll probably like this.
That depends on what cartoons you like.
Well, sure. I mean, if you like, you know, if you're fine with repetition, if you're fine with
screaming. If you can tolerate this fucking anime girls, you can probably handle this and stomach it a little better than I can.
If you're an anime man, you'll probably like this. So yeah, Miraculous Ladybug, love it or hate it, I think it's cool, good, all right, fun for the whole family. So give it a watch. Sure, do it if looking at it you think that looks kind of fun, then you'll probably enjoy it to at least a moderate extent.
Watch it with your friends.
Yeah.
Watch it with people that you have good rapport with. That
I watched it alone.
You always laugh with. Yeah. Yeah, you watched all of it alone.
And I loved it!
I'm a ladybug.
Did he say the boy has eaten too much spaghetti? No? I swear he says
that for the boy Adrian.
No, a while ago.
He means a smile when a mama brings in the spaghetti!
It's a tugging to lead you away. This whole time you've been all the way astray. Existence remains a paradox, but listen, there's a slight ringing, bringing the revolution of open locks.